What is good, guys? We have multi round for losers bracket. We got Floppy, aka Georgie, versus Ojama this time. And yeah, if you want to see the smog just chat, I'll add that in a few seconds or in a few minutes. It's not active at the moment. There are not that many people online on Smogtours. I'm pretty sure that not that many people knew that this game would happen, and luckily I was on Smogtours when it started, so we are here from the start. And we see Georgie brings an interesting offense team with Mega Pinsir. Pinsir and Thunder has two rock weaknesses, so this is probably a default Kartana. He's obviously just gonna fake out here. And looking at it, Ojama wants to switch out. Lopunny's definitely nice in this game, but he doesn't have good switch-ins. He can go into Landris here because Pinsir lost the Hypercutter because it Mega Evolved already. So you can get off the Intimidate. The thing is, a defensive Lando, it's most likely defensive Lando on Ojama's team, cannot do much back to Pinsir. It usually carries Rock, Simpower, Ice, Earthquake, and U-turn. So Pinsir can SD on Landris and kill it afterwards. But yeah, looking at it, Nihilego actually looks like a big threat to Georgie. When do you ever hear these words? Nihilego looks like a threat. That's a rare word. I'm thinking that the Nihilego is potentially Toxic Spikes as well. Because Suicune appreciates Toxic Spikes a lot. But yeah, I'm thinking it's a Scarf Nihilego for sure. And then maybe a Scarf or a Z... not Scarf. Maybe a Z-move or a Specs Lele. So he got up the rocks as Georgie got by SD and popped the Landris. So Nihilego is obviously gonna go for Power Gem here. This Pinsir gets scared out, and he doesn't really have anything to take two Power Gems. Maybe the Hooper can probably take two, but other than that, he doesn't have anything. Coco Spadef is not that good. It will get two hit KO'd. Kartana Spadef is complete dog shit, and Thunderous is obviously weak to it. And I think Azelf will also get two hit KO'd, especially after rocks. So it is the freest Power Gem of Ojama's life. I'm thinking that the Kartana is the Scarf on Georgie's team, but I'm not 100% sure. The Thunderous could be some setup variant. Nasty plot, either lefties or Z-move. The Zelf is obviously a rocker. I know Pinsir also learns rocks, but on this team, it's not gonna be rocks Pinsir. It's gonna be SD3 attacks, obviously. And yeah, Hooper's like his signature mon. I think he's like known to use it. He used it on the ladder as well to qualify for ulti, if I recall correctly. But yeah, Ojama obviously probably has Power Gem clicked ages ago already. Maybe he's running some Kallax. Georgie's running some Kallax. But Nihilego and Lele both look like super tough to deal with. Like for Floppy, like to switch into and to deal with. There's also like a Ferrothorn to check the Coco. And yes, Pinsir is a threat, yes, but Pinsir is forced out here, and if Pinsir comes back in, it's at 25%. And yeah, now the Smogtours chat are starting to get active. So I'm gonna change the dimensions. Yeah, Hooper is gonna be able to take two, I'm pretty sure, yeah. Potential, I don't know if that's a max HP variant. Potential trick room variant. Nice nickname, Unmon. But yeah, Nihilego is a pretty decent Spadef, so it's gonna be able to eat hits from the Hooper, but he doesn't want to stay in. I guess he knows that Nihilego can clean up late game for him. He goes into Suicune, and this is probably Protect Sub Scald Calm Mind, aka Vincune. So he can waste the trick room turn here by protecting. Actually, it's a bit risky on a potential nasty plot, but I assume that the Hooper is three attacks. Shadow Ball, Psy Shock or Psychic, and then Focus Blast is what I would assume. But yeah, the thing is, if Hooper takes another hit, you guys have seen Power Gem to 39, so it's gonna be in range from Power Gem if it takes another hit. Next. The only other thing that can take a Power Gem would be like the Kartana, but Kartana's Spadef is also pretty trash, so it cannot switch in. Like, I'm just talking about Nihilego, it's gonna be able to clean up late game, I'm pretty sure. You just get a burn, and Georgie gets a Spadef drop. So I assume he's, yeah, exactly, gonna protect. He wastes the Trick Room turn. And now he might try to go on a Ferrothorn. Because he can take a Shadow Ball with ease, kinda. Like, I would assume that the Ferrothorn has a good amount of spell death on his team, because the land is fizz death. Vinkun usually runs a lot of speed, so it's not that bulky on the spell death side. Or in general, before it sets up a Calm Mind, it's not that bulky on the spell death side. Even though that Shadow Ball didn't do that much, it actually did kinda jack damage. That was like dog shit damage, not gonna lie. So, is this Hooper even max special attack? Like, I assume that's a max HP Kun, but like, that did nothing. Like, what? Yeah, he can either... Does he need the Kun healthy for anything? Let me see. Not necessarily. I feel like Ojama just has like tools to win with the combination of Nihiligo, Lele. Yeah, he tries to predict the Ferrothorn there with the Focus Blast because he got this by Death Drop. So he probably thought that Ojama would switch into Ferro and waste the Trick Room turns like that. But yeah, he can... Gonna Coco here or... Huh. I guess he can go to Katana and try to defog, that would be another option because Ojama's Rock Set is already dead. But if he's really Scarf Katana, then he cannot make that play, because if he locks in defog and Kun goes for Protect and Ojama figures out that he's locked in the defog, then he can just stay in with Kun and Georgie is forced out and he doesn't have any good Scald switch in, so then he would be forced to sack something. Or to let the Coco weakened by switching it hard into Scald. So I don't think he's gonna go into I mean, he might go into Katana, but I don't think he's gonna defog. Like, I'm just thinking it would be nice for him to get rid of the rocks, but this is obviously not the turn he can afford to make that play if he's choice locked. I mean, it's either Katana or one of the electric types that is coming out here for sure. That's pretty obvious. But Georgie's like... He has like a lot of these weird HO teams, and last round was Blundy brought Stall, but yeah, at least he doesn't have Stall this time. The games are faster like this way, even though he's quite taking the time. Okay, so the Thundurus comes out here, he's obviously not gonna protect you on a potential setup Sandy. I assume he's gonna go hard to Nihiligo or hard to Ferrothorn. I feel like hard to Nihiligo is a pretty fine play, as it has, like I said earlier, it has pretty decent spadef. And the Thundurus, they're obviously, most of the time they're special. I have never seen a physical Thundurus Syrian. And they usually carry like Nasty Plot, T-Bolt, Empower Eyes of Flying, and then maybe Focus Blast. And what other, sometimes they run a Choice Scarf, but I don't think it's gonna be Choice Scarf on this team. But like on the low ladder you would see Choice Scarf. But I assume on this team it's like a setup variant. It's kind of quite interesting. It's like Hooper is like the only Trick Room setter. Like Hooper sets the Trick Room only for itself, is what I'm trying to say, because the other mons are quite fast. So they don't really like gain anything from Trick Room being up, but Trick Room is not going to be up that often anyway. Like it's just for Hooper. But yeah, I would just go hard Nihiligo here. Like the Trick Room is gonna end and then you're gonna outspeed it. I don't know why he went for Nasty Plot. I assume he predicted the Ferrothorn to come out. We do see he's a leftovers variant. So that tells us that the Z move is either on the Coco or Kartana. I think it's on Coco. I'm still thinking that Kartana is Scarf. But yeah, Power Gem is free again and Power Gem gets a kill. Katana resisted, yes, but Katana has dog shit speed death, so it would get 2-8 KO'd. Like, he was... Maybe he has Focus Blast and he Nasty Plot predicting the Ferrothorn, but I don't know, it was quite obvious that the Nihiligo could come out. And I'm thinking how he could have punished that. So he sacks off the Prince here. He's gonna get a Beast Boost plus one special attack. I'm trying to figure out how he could have punished the Nihiligo switch. Could have doubled into Kartana, I guess, but the rocks being on his side doesn't really help him. Like, even if he doubles, like, rocks on his side make this game like even harder for him. Like I said this a few times already, like Nelik is like a huge problem in this game. I assume that Cortana, like, it has thresh Bedev, but it can take this, yeah. Like, I assume that this should live with like 5 or 10, at least 5 or 10%, maybe it will live with a little bit more even. What's the base speed again? Katana's base speed is 109, I forgot Nihilego's base speed. I think it's 103. Actually, I don't remember. Nihilego is such an unmon, as you would say. Some people would say the 75, okay. So Smart Strike picks it up. Oh, he gets a speed boost, so this is a timid Cortana. That's another unset. That set, actually, you have to run timid, and you have to run not even max attack IVs, I think, so that Cortana has more speed than attack, and so that it gets a speed boost when it kills something. But I'm not really a fan of that set. It's pretty piss weak. Yeah, it can come in handy sometimes late game, but I don't like it. Like, I would just use, like, Scarf Cortana. So it's probably not Scarf if it's this set, the timid one. It's probably SD then. So he either doesn't have a Scarfer, or he's Scarf Coco or Scarf Azelf. At that point, I would say that he's maybe Scarf Coco. I mean, his speed control is basically the Trick Room Hoopa and the quick attack on Pinsir. But it's still quite weird to me on an offense like this if he doesn't have a Scarfer. But yeah, what Ojama can do here is, he can go to Ferrothorn. If he has quick attack on Lopunny, fake out into quick attack might kill. But I think he's gonna go Ferrothorn. Since this is timid, even if it has Sacred Sword, Ferrothorn is gonna eat it up. And he can go for like knockoff or something to pick this off. Yeah, like knockoff or Jarboll, whatever he has. Like, Jarboll is not that common anymore in Ferrothorn. Usually they run knockoff Power Whip, Leech Seed, and Spikes. So Georgie is potentially all out pummeling on this, so he could SD here, and then he might live a hit from the Ferrothorn, and then there's like a potential 50-50 if Ojama stays in on the all out pummeling. He wouldn't get arm bobs on the Cortana, and it would be bad for him. But doesn't knockoff bring this in range from fake out anyway? He switches into Tapu Lele. Oh, I think was he trying to scout for all out pummeling there, or what was he trying to scout for? But yeah, he's probably gonna go back into Ferrothorn here, expecting a Smart Strike, because he wants to get the Iron Barb's chip on this Cortana. Now he can't even fake it out if he needs to, because he set up the Psychic Terrain, but I'm pretty sure he's gonna try to kill it with Iron Barb's here. Yeah. But the thing is, if it has all out pummeling, that doesn't make contact. So he has to go back into the Lily here, expecting the all out pummeling. I mean, it's kind of 50-50. Did he go for all out pummeling? Yeah, he just went for Sacred Sword. Well, that was odd, because he would have died to recoil. So Jama's gonna try to go back in the furrow here to get Iron Bobs, and let's see if Georgie predicts that. He does predict that, and he goes for the Z move. Oh, it's Bloom Doom, that's why he didn't go for all out pummeling. That is an un-Z move, good god, as the Smokeless chat would say. What is this? Called it un-Z move. What is this? Bloom Doom Cortana. With timid nature, like, oof. You see this? Plus two Smart Strike doing some juicy chip to Kun. So you can just go for Scald here. I mean, he SD'd again expecting a switch into Ferrothorn, but Pretty sure the katana wasn't fake out range anyway. Why is he Suicune faster than the Thundurus? That's so weird. So it's probably bulky Thundurus. Really Espadefo HP invested. You can go into his Laupani here, or he can go into his, yeah. He's gonna fake out into return. And if this is Hidden Power Flying, it will do a good chunk to the Laupani, but yeah, I don't think it's gonna kill unless he crits. So yeah, Jama should have this game, but like, there was some weird turns, like, like, Timid Kartana is such a weird set. It's like something I would use for fun in a meme life. And like, I'm not trying to talk down on his team. Like, his team seems like really interesting and creative. I mean, I'm not an HO player at all, so like, HO gods might understand his team better than me. That's all I'm saying about his team. So he said, I want to nasty plot so bad, and I think he wants to. Maybe he wanted to bait Ojama to stay in, I'm not 100% sure, but like HP flying doesn't even kill, as you see there. Laupani 8. Yeah, it's only 60 base power exactly, and Laupani is not even that fried on the Spadef side. And it was also just a leftover Stundy, it didn't have like any boosting item like expert build or something like that. So there's the Azelf, it's gonna go for like Psyshock or Fire Blast, whatever it has. Now we might actually see if it's Scarf Azelf, if the Lob stays in. I don't think it is, but we shall see. But it's looking over. He can, I mean, he can just go to Tapu Lele here. Tapu Lele has... Eats up pretty okay, he stays in. Okay. I thought he might want to keep the Laupani around. Because, yeah, this was pretty obvious that it didn't kill the return. I mean, it actually almost killed. But, yeah, he can go for the. Doesn't really matter what he goes for because Moonblast and Psychic is same base power. And if Coco comes out, the terrain changes anyway. So, yeah, he's just going to weaken this Lele. Lele is going to pick off the Zelf. And Coco cannot win this game because there's a healthy Ferrothorn. The only way Coco can win if it hexes, maybe if it has Hidden Power Fire, yes, it can maybe win. It's always a lefty's Coco. Maybe it's like a, he has some interesting sets. So he's gonna taunt here. So he cannot get leash cheated. So this is gonna be. He doesn't have HP Fire. Otherwise, he would have gone for it. This is gonna be a Georgie trying to stall out Ferrothorn's power, but like. He only has 16 Roost PP and he has to keep taunting this. And Ferrothorn always gets lefties. So this is a losing scenario for Georgie. If he had Hidden Power Fire, he could have pulled this out, yeah. So yeah, I'm probably gonna upload game 1 and I'm gonna upload game 2 in a separate video, and depending if there's gonna be a game 3, I'm gonna upload that as well in a separate video. Dodge is a power up there. The thing is, if Ojama gets paralyzed eventually by Thunderbolt, then the turns he gets paralyzed, he doesn't use any PP. It's like I feel like there's just no way that Georgie wins this. Like, he has power up. And his other move should be knockoff. Did he show that yet? And he can also go for leech sheet or yeah, he shows knockoff. Yeah, so he got rid of the lefties. Yeah, he probably did that a few turns ago. Like, I just don't think there's that much to analyze here because the game is just over. Like, knockoff has a lot of PP. And on the turns that he gets taunted, he can also just try to go for leech sheet. Because then he doesn't waste any PP. And yeah, Coco's gonna run out of PP before Pharaoh. And he's also gonna run out of Roost eventually. Unless he dodges a lot of power whips. It's kinda annoying to me that they're playing this out because it's like pretty obvious to me that Ojama just wins this. But what can you do? I understand it keeps fighting, you obviously wanna try to win. This game actually was closer than I thought it would be. I thought that Ojama was like just sweep it nihiligo, but or like win higher, but oh well, didn't happen. I mean, yeah, you guys can read the Smokto shit. I don't really know what to talk about in this game here, because it's like repetitive and simple. Coco just can not really win this one on one. Like, I guess if he paralyzes the Ferrothorn and he keeps T-bolting, and the Ferrothorn gets full parried every turn, and he gets some crits here and there, then maybe. But I don't think so. Like, if the Ferro didn't have lefties, and he could get some crits here and there, then maybe he could do it. Yeah, he's also using his roost a bit too early, his roosts. I mean, I understand why he's using his roots, because he has to stay healthy, because he has to taunt this, and if he's not healthy and he taunts, then he dies to Power Whip. But yeah, it's just a losing battle for him, like I've said this a few times now. Yeah, Ojama's gonna take game one, and we're gonna be back with game two whenever this ends. Not whenever this ends, but in a separate video. But yeah, this is pretty ass at the moment. Like, some days it's better, some days it's ass. So uploading this is gonna take a while, huh? But I guess can expect game 2 like 1 or 2 hours later. Depending on... My brother's gonna go to sleep soon, I hope that I can keep narrating. Not that... If I can narrate game 2 live, I might have to re-narrate, we shall see. But yeah, you guys can just see what happens, and Gemma's just gonna take the victory. Let's see the PP. 13 times Thunderbolts left. 16 knockoffs and 9 power rips. And yeah, now he got off the lead sheet, that means the game is over. I mean, it was just a matter of time, even if he got up the lead sheet. Thank you guys for watching. A pretty odd game. And yeah, we shall see what Wild HO Floppy aka Georgie has for what Wild HO he pulls out in game 2. And yeah, Ojama has been performing quite well in these old T games, but this game was just super weird. I really don't know what to say about this game. Good lord, how would you categorize this? Timid Cartana versus and Nihiligo, like those are two unmons, as people would say. I'm just joking, I actually kind of like Nihiligo, even though it's not that good. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and we'll be right back with game 2 in 1 hour or so.